Welcome back to the online classes. Today we'll do history, pageants and parts. So I hope class 9 students are going through online classes. Stay safe and do your studies regularly at home. Today we'll do the next part, pageants and farmers. So far in our previous class we have learned that the pageants, they suffered so much, especially in England, due to the Enclosure Acts. They were driven out, they had to walk long distance to find work, and that too was uncertain. The wages were very low, and even the threshing machines were introduced due to modern technology, and they suffered more. So now, today we'll do 2.0. Bread basket and the dust bowl. So this is the another part we'll talk about, and there are 5-6 points I've written over here. Number one, we'll go through one by one. After studying about England, so far we have studied about England, the pageants and farmers. Let's go to USA, let's go to America, and how modern agriculture developed there. Let's see how modern agriculture developed there and how USA became the breadbasket of the world. Let's see how America became the breadbasket of the world and what this meant to the rural people of America. How America became the breadbasket? Because America was covered with thick forest. So a small number of white people from Europe, they traveled to America and settled in the eastern coast. But most part of the America was covered with thick forest. 70-80% of the land of the country was covered with thick forest. How it became the breadbasket of the world? Who did this? Who were the people who turned this forest into breadbasket or agricultural land? Let's talk about it. It's a long story. So what this meant to the rural people of America, the native people who originally lived there, what happened to them? Number two, when the common lands were being enclosed in England, we have learned that during 18th century, enclosure took place during two periods, 16th century for wool and 18th century for grain, food grain. Now when the enclosure was taking place during 18th century in England, settled agriculture had not developed extensively in USA, America. In America, extensively, agriculture was not done extensively, greatly. It had not developed. The native people over there, they used to live by hunting, gathering fruits, wild berries, fishing. They were nomadic in nature, by nature. So, while the enclosure was taking place during 18th century in England, settled agriculture had not developed extensively in America. So, forest covered over 800 million acres. You see that, the figure is given there. The country America was covered with thick forest, as I have told you. 800 million acres of land was covered with thick forest and wild animals lived there. And grassland about 600 million acres. You can see that. Grasslands, tall, tall grasses in the central part of America. It has a grassland, and about 600 million acres of grassland over there, and 800 million acres of forest. This shows that. Here is a picture. Now you can see the picture over here. The dark portion is the thick forest, and the light green portion is the moderate forest, a little tall grasses, and the light green portion is the small short grasses, and you can see the grasses over there, forest, the dark blue is the forest. and here is the Rocky Mountains, and here is an Appalachian Mountains. This is an Appalachian Mountain, and the white settlement was only over here. The white settlement live over here, and this portion was settled by the native people, the Red Indians. Red Indians, this area belonged to Red Indians. The white people who came from Europe lived on this eastern shore, and there is an Appalachian Mountain. And they crossed the mountain and saw the forest, the land, good land, and they cultivated. So now they came one after another, like waves, they came from Europe and settled over there, and the native people were pushed behind towards the western side, and finally they had to go to the rocky areas, and this land was taken over by white people. So now we'll talk about that. So forest covered, I've shown you the forest cover over here. It's a dark portion is the forest, thick forest cover, and it's a tall grass and it's a short grass, and here is again forest, and this is a rocky mountains. On both sides there are mountains. On the eastern side there is an Appalachian Mountain, and on the western side there are Rockies. So the native people were pushed behind. We'll talk about later in our next slide. So forest cover over 800 million acres, and grassland covered 600 million acres were covered with grass. Such a huge area. Number four, most of the landscape of America, the land was America, of America, was not under white Americans. I've told you already, I've shown you, this land was not under white Americans. White Americans means the people who came from Europe. They settled over here, a few number of white people, they came over here, America, during Columbus time, Christopher Columbus time. They settled over here in the eastern part, near the seashore. They have not crossed the Appalachian Mountains. So, most of the landscape was not under white Americans. White American means the people who came from Europe and settled there. They are white Americans. Till 1780s, most of the land was not under white Americans or the Europeans who came there and settled there. White settlements were confined means isolated, to a narrow eastern shore, a narrow strip of eastern shore, as I have shown you. Number five, various native people, various groups, you can see their various names are there in your book also, you can look through that, go through that. Various native people, and these people were called Red Indians. Various native people, and the bracket I have written over here, Red Indians, lived in groups in the western part of Appalachian Mountains. They lived in groups here, various groups are there. Towards the western side of this Appalachian Mountain, towards the west, they lived there. Not towards the east of Appalachian Mountain. They lived towards the western part of Appalachian Mountain. Several of these native people, original inhabitants of America, they are called Red Indians. The several of these natives were nomadic. They were nomadic. They used to keep animals and move around in the forest, grasslands. They were nomadic, and some were settled. Some Red Indians, native people, they settled over there and they did the farming for their survival. Some were settled. Some lived by hunting and gathering fruits. Hunting, fishing, gathering fruits. They lived in this way. They had no problems regarding food. The forest was full of wild animals. It was so thick. So the forest was very, very thick. Tall grasses were there. Short grasslands were there. Tall grasslands were there. 600 million acres of grasslands were there. Tall and short grasses. 800 million acres of forest. So they had no problem regarding food. They used to live by hunting, gathering fruits. Some were settled and did a small little farming over there, and some used to herd at their animals, cattle. So they had no problem. The problem started after 1780s, when the white Americans or the Europeans who settled there, they were called white Americans. When they came, when they cross over the Appalachian Mountain, then the problem started. These people who had to fight in order to survive, in order to protect their areas, and many times they lost and they were driven. So many tribes were killed. So they were driven towards the western side. So now what happens after that? It's a very kind, quite interesting. So now we'll continue in our next class. What happens after that? So that's all for today. Stay safe and study regularly at home. I hope you are doing the same. So don't waste time. That's all for today. Thank you for watching the video.